and welcome to The Art of Being Human. Today we're going to start a whole new series on chronic illnesses. Now, I've done chronic illnesses before, but I never completed the process. I actually talked about quite a few chronic illnesses, and then I talked about diabetes, which is a chronic illness, and we spent 7 months on diabetes. And then after that, I thought we needed a break. So I talked about psychology in general, what it is, what it can do, what it can't do, and how to have relationships and how to understand other people and know how people react to you. And we went through a lot of things like that. So now I want to go back and finish the chronic illnesses that I didn't finish before. I'm not going to repeat what I've done before, except maybe in rare instances, but I want to continue because there's a lot of them. And when you think of a chronic illness, you have to understand that a chronic illness is an illness that never goes away. When you get it, you'll have it for the rest of your life. Now, you can still lead a good life with it if it's treatable, but sometimes, you know, you're going to have some limitations. So these are the chronic illnesses. And there's been a lot in the news about TCE, about football injuries, about opioids and what they do to you, and what's happening with heroin, and how come the heroin crisis is as bad as it is. So I'm going to start with the football injuries first. But let me tell you a little bit about the human brain, because it involves concussions and what the brain can take and what the brain can't take. But I've noticed over the last few months that there are more and more articles and more talks about people who have concussions from football injuries and how it affects them and how sick they get. And to the point where I've heard doctors actually say on television, these are doctors for ABC, NBC, and so forth, that say that if they have children growing up that want to play football, they would not allow them to play football because there's so much damage to the brain from continual concussions and continual hits. So I thought I'd go into that first. So if you take a look at the diagram I have here on the human brain, exactly what happens in a concussion and why is it so important that we stay free of them. So this is the human brain. I just did this sketch a couple days ago. And I'm not going to go into the various lobes and the cerebellum and the medulla and all of that, but what I want to do is just talk about the brain. The brain is very, very well protected. You have three layers of tissue on top of the brain, and then you have the skull on top of that. And so the brain is very well cushioned, and it should be protected. But if you're going to play football, and if you're going to hit it, and hit it, and hit it, and hit it, then what's going to happen is the brain is going to start moving in the skull. It can move a little bit. It's protected so you wouldn't think it would, but it actually has the ability to move a little when you're being hit. Even though it's protected, it still has the ability to move. So what do? You get parts of the brain rubbing up against the skull, rubbing up against the tissue, and then you actually can take and shear off in a hard hit. You could actually shear off some of the tissue in the top of the brain, so you have a little less tissue there. And that's a brain injury. And what that is a concussion. Now, a concussion can heal so that you wouldn't necessarily have any long-lasting effects from it other than a temporary thing, usually dizziness and, you know, not being able to think straight and maybe a little balance problem and stuff like that. You would know that you weren't quite right on. I had a minor concussion once when somebody dropped a table on my head. I don't want to explain the circumstances of how that happened, but it was a couple of teenagers, and they decided to lift the table over my head at a group meeting I was having, and they dropped it and it landed on my head. And I ended up with a minor concussion. And I can tell you, the effects I had, I did have a terrible headache because of the pressure of the table on my head. And I want to mention here that the brain itself does not feel pain. You could stick a knife through the brain, it wouldn't register pain for itself. It just doesn't. But all of the tissues around it will register pain. It's just the brain itself that doesn't register pain for itself. So I had a terrible headache, but I noticed my balance wasn't quite right. My vision wasn't quite right. I was a little bit lightheaded. Not bad, though. I mean, I could walk and around and I could talk. Things didn't quite seem real to me. And it was a concussion that I had, but it was a minor concussion. It wasn't a bad concussion. What happens in football, a person will have a concussion, they're not right, the brain hasn't healed, and they go right back and play. And they get another concussion on top of that concussion. So they get concussion after concussion after concussion. How long it takes to heal from a concussion, I suppose, will depend upon how serious it was to begin with. Nonetheless, concussions can be very serious, and to repeat it over and over and over again, that's very dangerous to the brain. There are people who can't walk in midlife because of brain injuries due to concussions. There are people who can't think right, can't speak right, they cannot live a normal life. Now, that's chronic. The chronic condition. A chronic illness is an illness that doesn't go away. Sometimes it's genetic, like, for example, diabetes, which I think is genetic, and other illnesses that are genetic. But you can also have chronic illnesses from injuries, and injuries such as concussion, where the damage is permanent. So when we think of chronic illnesses, there are illnesses or conditions. I'm going to say both. Illnesses are conditions that don't remit, they're always there, and you will always have them. Now, if it's a genetic thing, then you could say diabetes and some illnesses, whenever they show up, it can be in the genes. They don't necessarily show up at birth. For some diabetics, it doesn't show up till midlife. And some mental illnesses doesn't show up in midlife. But other chronic illnesses come from injuries. And when a person is injured, the injury cannot heal or you can't recover from it. And I'm thinking in terms of brain injury mainly. But you know, a person falls off the roof and they're paralyzed and they're in a wheelchair for the rest of their life. That's a chronic injury. They didn't get it because of anything that had to do with genetics. It was due to an accident. Or if they're in an auto accident and they received an injury that they're not going to get over, same thing. It's chronic. But getting to the brain, when you start moving the brain tissue around in the head and shearing off the tissue, then you've got a concussion, and it's a very bad thing. It's an injury to the brain. If you looked it up in a dictionary, the dictionary a definition of a concussion would be injury to the brain due to jarring from a blow or a fall or a hit. Same thing. Who is at risk for brain injuries due to concussions? Well, football players particularly, because they're always hitting their heads. But soccer players do the same thing, and they're at risk as well. Hockey players, how would a hockey player get a concussion? Banging into the wall, slamming into the wall when they're skating. That will do it. They're going at a certain speed, and then they suddenly stop. They're jolted, stop, because they're either hit by somebody or they run into the wall. And here the brain is moving inside the skull. So you have that. And other people, wrestlers, they hit their heads on the floor. Car races, they slam against the wall if they're in an accident and this car stop quickly. So the sports that aren't quite so prone is going to be like baseball players or skaters or gymnasts, where they're normally not landing on their heads. Anytime a person lands on their heads or repeatedly takes a hit to the head is in danger of having some kind of a brain injury from that. So, the injury that you get and what football players have is called chronic traumatic encephalopathy, and it is actually abbreviated CTE, so that's probably what we're going to call it. So I want to give you some more information on the brain. The brain does not become well developed until age 25. You are not grown to completion, as far as the brain is concerned, until mid-20s. And different parts of the brain grow at different rates of speed at different times. For example, as a child is developing, there'll be a few weeks when the frontal lobe will be growing very fast, and then that slows down, and another part of the brain, let's say the cerebellum, grows very fast, and then that slows down, and different lobes. lobes of the brain kind of take their turn in growing, but they grow at different times and they grow rapidly. Now, if a mother, this is just an example, if a pregnant mother gets sick, say she has measles, measles can be may be devastating to a developing fetus because it can injure what's growing the most. If the brain is growing the most and the measles attack the fetus, then it could be that the child ends up by being retarded. If it's the eye area of the brain that's attacked by the measles virus, if that's the area of the brain that's growing the fastest, the child could be born blind, or if it's the ears, they could be born deaf. So different parts of the brain grow at different rates, at different times, and if a mother is sick or in an accident or has something happen to her, then the part of the brain of the baby that's growing the fastest or the part of the body of the baby that's growing the fastest will take the hit. And so therefore, it's important to stay away from all kinds of accidents and injuries when you're pregnant, because you don't know how much that's going to affect the human baby. So the brain can be affected, and we don't know what happens to a growing brain if the brain is injured while playing football. Now, you have all of these kids playing football and hockey and all of that when they're young, these little junior leagues, and even though they have their helmets on, injuries are still possible. And the question is, and I don't have an answer for the question, frankly, but the question is, what happens to the developing brain if the brain is still growing, it's not mature, it just is growing and gradually developing, and the brain is injured while it's still growing and has not come to maturity? What happens to the human brain? Can it develop normally, or will a person always grow up and have some kind of a disability because they were injured or parts of their brain were injured while it was still growing at a young age? I know I have heard doctors, especially I'm thinking about ABC News, where the doctor is saying if he had a child that wanted to play football and they were just growing up, they were young, he would not allow them to play football because of the injuries. So the chronic traumatic encephalopathy is a progressive degenerative disease, brain disease, and it has to be diagnosed post-mortem. You find out in an autopsy. You can't diagnose it before the person dies, but you certainly can suspect it because some of the symptoms are very dramatic. So here are some of the symptoms due to multiple concussions that a person has from playing football, although it can happen, as I said before, in soccer and other things as well. The CTE symptoms include headache, disorientation, confusion, poor judgment, dementia, slow muscle movements, staggered gait, tremors, and it's caused by brain trauma, and it is not genetic. It has nothing to do with something being wrong with your genes, and it's just showing up. That happens in other illnesses, multiple sclerosis and other illnesses, but it doesn't show up. CTE is due to brain injury, and it's mostly found in professional athletes, football, wrestling, contact sports where the head is involved, and sometimes in military service too, with the exercises that they do, they can get injured with that. So some people also, when they get CTE, commit suicide. They can become very depressed because they're disabled now, and as a result of that, some of them commit suicide. I have a list. I'm not going to give out names, but I took a list from an article of how some people died when they had CTE. A football player died in 2011 of temporal dementia. He had dementia. He couldn't think right. Why? Due to football injury, due to CTE. And there was another hockey player, and he died in 2009 of CTE. And then there was a wrestler who killed his wife, and he had his brain examined, and then he committed suicide, and all of that due to CTE. How did they find out? Well, if they do an autopsy of the brain, they'll find what the brain injury was, and then since so many people are going to be violent or committing suicide or not functioning well after they've retired from football, then you know it has to be related to football injuries or possibly concussions, generally concussions, and the people become, their behavior becomes erratic and they kill themselves, they sometimes hurt other people. There was a person, I'm not mentioning his name, age 50 years old, he shot himself, and the note that he left, the note said he wanted to leave his brain to science to see what was wrong with it because he wanted to kill people. You know what it was? He had CTE. There's another person who shot and killed his girlfriend and then committed suicide. Studies after his death showed that he had CTE. And there was another person, football, who had memory lapses, and it is felt due to CTE. So it is a bad thing to have, and it all comes from football injuries due to the brain, repeated concussions. Now, I came across an article, and I thought it was interesting. This is fairly recently, and I took this out of a magazine. And what it says, I'm going to kind of read it. It was a former NFL wide receiver. I'm not giving his name. He won a Super Bowl with the Pittsburgh Pirates in 2005. 36 years old, and he had to retire. He can no longer walk downstairs. He has trouble walking downstairs, and he wishes he'd played another sport instead, such as baseball. He says, I wouldn't be surprised if football isn't around in 20 or 25 years. He feels that the injuries are going to be severe enough that people are just not going to be willing to play. Now, it's one thing if an adult knows the risk, and they play, and they make a decision that it's worth the risk for what they get out of it. But to put a child through it and allow a child who isn't old enough to make decisions into a situation where they could get some brain injury playing in little leagues and little football leagues, then I have my questions about that. So what this football player is saying, he thinks at some point that football will just, you know, phase out. It won't be a sport anymore due to the fact that so many of them are injured with CTE. And, you know, for a lot of people for CTE, a lot of people, the football league never did admit, but it's doing so now, but years ago, they would never admit that football playing and concussions had anything to do with the problems that these football players had. They just would not admit it. They wouldn't pay compensation. But now they've gotten to the point where they really don't have a lot of choice. There is a definite relationship between constant hits of the head and injuries and what happens with the brain because it damages the brain. Now, I think I have enough time to do this. I came across an article written by a football player who is alive and now has retired, and he explains what he goes through on a daily basis just to live now that his football career is over. He has a lot of injuries. And he describes what his body is like. He says one ankle is purple and swollen. The hip is constantly in pain. His ribs sting even with the slightest touch. His lower back has piercing pain. His shoulders feel like they are on fire. And when he gets up, this is what he has to go through when he gets up. He carefully gets out of bed by shimmying to the edge of the bed, letting his legs hang over, and sits there for a while until he can get his balance and until he feels that he can stand up. He lowers his sore feet to the floor, and he sits there for more minutes. Then he hoists himself up, and he limps to the bathroom. On some days, he can't go downstairs. He has to go down in a sitting position because he can't stand up and walk downstairs. So what he does is he sits down right on his backside, and he slides himself down step by painful step by its painful step, sitting and going down that way until he finally gets to the bottom of the steps. And all the while, he is going through excruciating pain. Now, he didn't have an acute injury. He wasn't unconscious, but what he did was he played football and he had hits to his head, repeated hits, and they weren't so serious that he ever stopped playing. He played normal football, but then finally it caught up with him and he got CTE, and now he's quite disabled because of it. But it wasn't a major accident or a major trauma that caused it. It was the repeated milder hits that you take in a game over and over and over again. It has a cumulative effect, because what happens with football players is they get an injury, it may not seem all that bad, but they don't let it heal because they have another game the following week, so they have one injury on top of another injury on top of another injury, so that they are injured repeatedly and they do not have enough time to heal between games, so they're really playing injured and adding more injury on top of what they already got. So this is just the wear and tear on the body due to football. Now, I'm not opposed to football playing. I mean, it's something that people enjoy, and I enjoy watching it too, but I think you have to start paying attention to what is actually happening to the human body, and in the case of CTE, what is actually happening when you have brain hits all the time, and especially with children who want to play, they want to be just like their famous stars, and what are those hits doing to their young developing brains? If I had a child, I don't, but I wouldn't let them play football. I would have them choose something else instead. So I'm going to close it here. We're about out of time, and we're going to go into the opioids and a lot of problems with the opioid pain pills and how it leads to heroin addiction, and there's a lot of talk about that. So I'm going to be going into that next time. So please join me then.